my name is Tony Armour, and I've always been a big comic book fan. So I read The Punisher as a kid and a teenager, and I was pretty interested in the character. I heard they were coming to Tampa to film the movie here. I sent my headshots into the casting agency, and really had forgotten about it. And then a few months later, I got a phone call, and they asked if I wanted to come out to the set and work on the set as a photo double for Thomas Jane for the day. And of course I said yes. I was a stand-in and a photo double, but I'm not really in the movie. So it's fun to be able to act a little bit, even though maybe it's not very good. But just to feel like you're in the movie and you're part of the film. This is the tenement building, which was used as Frank Castle, aka the Punisher's apartment in the movie. And it looks a little different now than it looked when they actually filmed here. They had built a platform and an awning and had the GTO out here. There was an old beat up minivan over here, and there were couches and just bits and pieces of junk. They had a little garden alongside the front of the building here, and they did some work with Rebecca Romijn Stamos, you know, doing her gardening. The car was right around this area here, and the stand-in stuff that I did basically involved me sitting in the car at one point with this grinder and shooting off sparks on a skid plate to show these sparks, like he was doing some work in the car. He had a bulletproof shield inside the car that he would pull down that go over the windshield, and I had a hand drill, and I would sit there with this power drill and pretend I was working on the screen, and then pull the screen down and just kind of, you know, look around a little bit. So that was fun. I had a wig on, a black wig, and the whole Punisher jeans and white t-shirt. It was kind of weird having this big old strange wig on my head that they had the makeup artist sitting there trimming and cutting on and everything, and they actually shaved my arms and then put makeup on my arms so there was the same skin tone as Thomas Jane's as well. So it was fun, pretty entertaining. This is the courthouse scene in the movie where Frank Castle comes back into town, and there's a big press conference.
Where have you been?
It's been 5 months since my family was killed, and I don't see one man in jail.
Obviously, you're upset.
Upset? Is that the word? I used to get upset when I got a flat tire. I used to get upset when my flight was delayed. I used to get upset when the Yankees won the series. If that's what upset means, then how do I feel now? This is the office building that doubles as the Saints office complex. Frank Castle enters this building, goes to one of the upper level floors, and takes a bunch of Howard Saints money and throws it out the window to the street below to a bunch of the normal working class Joes, and a little bit of frenzy created in the street as they're all scrambling for Howard Saints money. There's a standoff between Frank Castle and two of Howard Saints' henchmen in the lobby. And they had a glass sign set up at one side. One of the guys gets blown through the piece of glass. At the far end of the lobby, what they built was a fake wall to blank out the open end that you see there right now. After he guns the henchman down, then he walks through the lobby and exits out those doors on the opposite side of the lobby. This is the David Falk Theater right here, where actually they film a scene in the movie where Howard Saint's wife actually came to see the Buenos Dias Pablo Film Festival. Frank Castle takes a fire hydrant out of a bag and sets it next to the spot where she parks her car in front here. Oddly enough, you actually can't park your car in front of the theater here because it's just lanes of traffic, so they had the street blocked off for the film. This drawbridge was used in the film for a little action sequence where Frank Castle actually jumps the drawbridge as he's being chased by Hitman Harry Heck. It's right near I-275 in downtown Tampa. As Castle is sitting in the GTO waiting for the drawbridge to drop, Harry Heck, the assassin, is coming up behind him in another green GTO. In order to escape from Hitman Harry Heck, Castle has to take his car and jump it over the drawbridge before it is fully dropped. He flies across the drawbridge and comes down this road here. After Castle jumps the drawbridge, he speeds along this street here. He flips the GTO onto its roof. With the GTO flipped over, the Punisher crawls out of the car, and this is where we have the final confrontation between Hitman Harry Heck and the Punisher.
You are one dumb son of a bitch. Bring a knife to a gunfight.
This building right here is the Bank of America building in Tampa. This doubled as the Saints and Sinners nightclub in the movie. When they established the Saints and Sinners nightclub in the film, you can see the cars pulling up through this entrance right here, and across the street is a car lot. There's an actual sign that they put up that says Saint Motors to show and establish that Howard Saint owns a car dealership across the street. The courtyard of the building here was used for the arrival point of all the local celebrities and everyone that was coming to the club. They had these alcoves all lit in red, so you had this kind of red glow coming out of here as this was lit up at night. They gave it a really cool kind of a look. They also had a large pedestal with a flame, almost like an eternal flame kind of thing going here. At the climax of the film, there's a large explosion. The Saints and Sinners nightclub gets blown up. In the film, they actually used some practical effects. They flipped a car over. One of the large torches was knocked over. In the final scene in The Punisher, after the explosion, Frank Castle walks through the courtyard to get to Howard Saint, where he's going to exact his final bit of revenge. The Punisher actually attaches Howard Saint's leg to the back of the car and drags him across the street into Saint Motors, and the entire digitally enhanced parking lot gets blown up, and it's a large skull-shaped image.